Welcome back. We are live here from the Newseum in Washington, D.C., where the front pages from all 50 states are aligned outside. This week, the New York Observer made headlines after it endorsed Donald Trump for president. The reason why that's notable is because the newspaper is owned by Donald Trump's son-in-law, Jared Kushner. The editorial included this caveat. Donald Trump is the father-in-law of the Observer's publisher. That is not a reason to endorse him, but giving millions of disillusioned Americans a renewed sense of purpose and opportunity is a reason. Now, the day after that endorsement was published, one of the paper's top political reporters announced he was resigning. His name is Ross Barkan, and he joins me now from New York. So, Ross, you are the national political reporter there. You're leaving in 2 weeks. Why did you decide to resign from The Observer?
Well, Brian, it was a confluence of factors. One factor, obviously, was the endorsement. I had expected our newspaper, given our deep ties, or assumed naively that we would perhaps remain neutral. I was blindsided by the endorsement. But a bigger issue, which maybe got lost in the shuffle a bit, was the fact that it was reported that our editor-in-chief had a role in advising Donald Trump before he delivered a speech in front of the AIPAC conference last month. And for me,
right, that he was looking at the draft of the speech. And he has said he will not do that again. The Observer has said that the staff is free to report on Trump. Do you not believe that the handcuffs are off and that you are allowed to cover Trump like any other candidate?
I would like to believe that I am, and I want to believe the organization. I have a lot of respect for the organization. I just felt my position was becoming untenable, and it was time for me to go. I think The Observer probably still can cover national politics and do it well, but given what had happened for me personally, a line had been crossed, and I thought it was time for myself to depart.
Do you expect other staffers to leave as well, other political reporters and editors?
I don't want to speak for them. It'll be their personal decision. I know it's been a trying few months at The Observer. At the same time, that's their decision, and I'll let them announce it when they're good and ready.
It sure is a complex ethical question. You don't have a next job lined up, do you? So this has been tough for you personally, hasn't it?
It's been a little difficult. Certainly, I don't have a job lined up right now. There's been a little interest, but nothing set in stone. I don't know where I'm going next. So financially, sure, it's not the best thing. At the same time, I've gotten a lot of support from this, so I can't say it's been horrendous. It's been a very interesting few days, I'll put it that way.
I bet it has. If nothing else, a reminder to pay attention to who owns the media you're reading and watching. Ross, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.